I pour one.
You pour one. Anyone?
That's too low.
It's too low.
I think this song just low.
Oh, you turned on the phone. Mm-hmm.
Can you hear the music?
I'm trying to see y'all. Man. Yep.
You got anybody?
Or just you?
We wasted a good song.
Mm-hmm.
You think them, you think it looks straight?
Mm-hmm.
In my head, it don't be straight though.
My comments on? I don't know how to say it.
Man, your comments ain't comments off. Comments on, man. I got a lot of stuff.
Well,
that's because I researched Bacardi, Florida Connor, and the Hemingway.
Oh, yeah.
I'm
trying to manage to get one here, though.
Man.
Heavy. Come through.
I know. Just got in. Okay, so we get some people. What's up, y'all? We're just trying to wait before we start talking for more people to come in.
Cheers, a shot.
Well, is it a shot here? Mm-hmm.
You got a shot of yours?
It's a little more. It's like this. All right, what's up, y'all? What's up, y'all? More people in. I think, but y'all think slow, bro. It's driving me.
I know. All right. Ooh.
I take a moment. That's me every time I take a shot. I'm not taking the whole thing.
But you'll drink a cocktail within like 5 minutes.
I drink the hell out of a cocktail. All right, what's up, y'all? How y'all doing tonight? Five people. What's up? What's up, Darius? Yeah, we're still waiting. When we get to 10, we'll probably start. If y'all want to just talk about something, we can do that. How was your day?
Long.
Well,
ripping and running.
Yeah.
How about your day?
It was good. Ripping and running as well. You see, we're working with Rum tonight.
Woo! First Thursday of March.
Hey.
Yeah.
This year, it was a little rough for us.
Oh, dang.
Because, you know, that's when it was breaking out. Everything was going on.
The world was ending around this time.
Yeah. So. I remember watching at the bar work that, looking on the TVs, watching New Jersey. That was the last place to close before us bars closed. I'm like, we next, bro. Wasn't nobody in there.
Oh, my goodness.
It was scary. We had paper
menu. I don't think about this. It's
traumatic, right? For a whole year. It's super traumatic.
Happy March, y'all.
Happy March.
Today's rum day.
Yeah. We got Bacardi Limon. Florida Cana, got some soda water right here. We got an already made mojito right here.
Yeah.
And we have, it's kind of sad, I really wanted Luxardo Maraschino liqueur, but because we were so busy, I know, I want to say
I didn't really think about that.
It was just background noise. I was really sad we couldn't get the Luxardo Maraschino liqueur because the bars were so busy because we opened back up to capacity. But we got the herring cherry liqueur, and I didn't even try it beforehand.
I was thinking about that. I should have been trying.
Yeah, we should try it. Because it's not too late, but let's just be surprised.
We'll try later.
All right. Oh, you have to update it. Alright, I'm trying to get to 10, y'all, but in a minute, I'll probably go ahead and start, because I don't really like to keep, lagging on, you know. But I also thought about, too, it's springtime now, and the people are out.
Yeah,
we at capacity now, you know. I know Twa's doing something tonight.
Hey, don't forget about us, y'all know, too.
What?
We held y'all down when y'all had nothing to do.
Yeah, we're the quarantine crew.
You said what? With quarantine crew.
Right.
Quarantine right. Information.
But yeah, hey, so I'm gonna work with rum tonight. Made with sugar cane. Yeah, it is what it is. If you go to the beach, if you have any tiki cocktails, anything like that, where I work at Cannibal and Craft, we make tiki cocktails, and a lot of them are with different types of rum. Rums have a wide range of stuff.
Yeah, let them know what a tiki drink is.
A tiki drink is basically like a beach drink. I don't know the history of why they call it a tiki drink. Maybe I should
look that island up. Sweet drinks.
Yeah, like blue Hawaiians.
Pina coladas. I guess you can say medical marijuana. See, it was marijuana. What you call it? Liquid marijuana. Did you say it's like a tiki? No.
I don't know if I would consider it tiki, but it does have rum in it, and it is a beach drink. But that's very interesting. I'm gonna ask Jared what he considers liquid marijuana a tiki drink.
Okay.
I never make it over crushed ice. Maybe I should start. Yeah, especially drinks that are so sweet. You know, it works with the crushed ice.
So I can't see the.
Oh yeah, Jamaican drinks. What's up? What's up, Drea? How you doing? I don't know why you can't see the comments. We're about to start now, though, because I'm impatient and I'm tired of waiting. All right, so Taylor, Bam, we're the whole part of Mixed. Squares got you tonight.
Squarey.
Anyway, we're going to make a mojito because it's springtime. It's time to go to the beach. I know I am the first one running there.
Oh, man. I can't wait to go to the beach.
Right. Listen, I want to go to the beach so bad. They told me I had to wear a mask. I'm like,
dude. Bless you. Okay. All right. Can I take it out when I drink?
I'm just going to drink the whole time. I'm just going to have it like, on my ear.
Just put a straw in between your mask.
I know. I want an excuse to take it out.
To get it off.
So we're making rum-based drinks because we're ready to go to the beach, we're ready to party, we're ready to get spring break started.
It's coming.
Yeah, it's coming strong too. I think everybody's ready.
Yeah.
So we're Taylor, Bam, Mixed, rum drinks, the mojito, and the Hemingway daiquiri. Not a daiquiri that you guys probably think of, like that's frozen in a blender and stuff like that. It's a little bit different than that. Yeah. It's served up in a martini glass. Up means like in martini glass.
Yeah, no ice.
Yeah, no ice.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to give you guys a little bit of history. You know what I'm saying about it? I'll give Bacardi's history later, but we can do that. Mojito.
Okay.
So tonight I'm using Floridacana. That's going to be the rum for the Hemingway daiquiri. We have a different rum for the mojito that we're going to use. It's a really good recipe. It's a lemon rum.
That happened.
And you can't take it back or edit it out or anything. All right. So, first, we're going to talk about the Floridacana. Man, the air's kicking. It's made in Nicaragua. Am I saying that right? If I'm not, I guess they're making funny. Nicaragua? That's right?
What is it?
Nicaragua. What's what I'm using tonight. It dates back to 1890. It wasn't official in the market until 1937 over there, not over here. It started to be exported in 1959 to Venezuela, Costa Rica, and other South American countries. Let's see. They started because they had the Nicaraguan war revolution going on. Okay. They started to harvest large amounts. By 1990, they had the largest aged reserve in the world of rum.
In the 90s.
Yeah, okay. Because of the war, the revolution that was going on. They also sponsored a PGA tour and a fishing tour, like international fishing tour. Well,
okay.
That's about that. It's called an Ernest Hemingway daiquiri. If you aren't familiar with who Ernest Hemingway is, he's a journalist, a short story teller, even says sportsman in there. I didn't know that.
I didn't see that.
Yeah.
We kind of talked about him last week, if y'all remember, but whatever.
Yeah, we did. We did talk about him last week. He actually lived in Cuba from 1939 until shortly after the Cuban Revolution. And we're going to get into the revolution when we talk about Bacardi. In 1954, they threw him a party after he won the Nobel Prize of Literature.
Ernest?
Yeah.
Okay.
He also mentioned Bacardi and some of his stories, to have and have not, and also for whom the bells toll, which is also a J. Cole song. Just wanted y'all know that.
Shout out to J. Cole.
Yeah, he tried it at a bar called Florida's. That's where he tried it, at Florida's in Cuba. It's the oldest bar there known to date. It was in the oldest part of Cuba, so I would assume it's the oldest And the drink was later modified with grapefruit juice. We got grapefruit juice.
Grapefruit juice with a drink is so good.
Yeah. Ernest Hemingway also gets a lot of credit for, like, you're going to get into later, a lot of drinks made in Cuba. A lot of tiki drinks, I guess, like, it's very interesting, but I guess since he was kicking it over there, you know.
Shoot.
Yeah,
I mean, could you imagine Cuba at that time?
I know. But it's probably scary because they had the revolution going on.
Yeah. Yeah, probably
was.
Scary and beautiful at the same time.
Right. It's a scary, beautiful mess. Okay. We're going to get started because it's what? It's 8:15. That's long enough, right?
Oh, okay.
All right. We're going to use 2 ounces of my Florida Kona. I just told y'all all about it. Boom.
You said 2 ounces?
2 ounces, yeah. Big side, 1 ounce. Other side, 1/2 ounce. Boom. We're going to use 3/4 lime, so I'm going to flip it over. It would help if I take this top off. Alright. Boom. 1/2 ounce of grapefruit, which I don't agree with, so I'm actually gonna do 1 ounce.
Is that how much? That's
a
lot. 1/2 ounce?
It's 1/2 ounce of grapefruit. I don't trust that recipe. I don't like that one. And then we have our cherry liqueur that I'm gonna use. I was telling y'all about earlier. I'm gonna use 3/4 of that. Alright. I want to give y'all some room to be able to see. I feel like they can't really see what's on the table. Alright. We got everything in here. Give it some shake. So, like I said, it's served up in the martini glass, right? Alright. So, we're going to see. This is my first time making it. Well, I've made it at the bar I work at, but this is my first time making it at home. Oh, it's about the same color.
Ooh.
Pretty, right? Oh, I said I was going to make it look extra new. I had the lime, the one without the slit.
Ooh.
That was a very heavy lime.
It is heavy.
I thought it was going to come back up. It didn't even come back up.
I like when they seek at the bottom, though.
You do?
Yeah, look at that.
Ooh, yeah, that's pretty. Can y'all see that? Alright. Damn. Dang.
Huh. Dang changer?
Yeah. So what I'm going to do is, because I'm going to make her a little bit of a shot of one, I'm going to... like kind of modify it in my hand. I'm just gonna freehand it, and I'm pretty sure it'll be right.
Cool.
Yeah, bring me one.
Huh.
Bring me one. I'm gonna make her a little bit of, I'm gonna make her a shot. This is how a lot of times even at work, if I like a drink, I'll make it as a shot.
Yeah.
You know.
I love that, like, the
color.
Orange.
Yeah, that's pretty color. Alright, there you go. So, it's a little bit darker, but I feel like it should taste good.
Cheers. Cheers. It's the cherry liqueur.
Yeah.
Is it a creamy,
it didn't even need it didn't even need simple syrup.
No. Could you imagine simple syrup? It's just sugar.
Yeah, and thick.
Yeah. Y'all should order these at bars and stuff.
Yeah, kidding. The Hemingway daiquiri, man. That's fire.
Mm-hmm.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
It's really good. It's delicious. It tastes like... You can taste the sweetness of the sugar cane from the rum, but that lemon or the lime juice balances it one way, and then the cherry liqueur balances back another way. You know what I'm saying? So it makes it an excellent drink. That bottle is covering the shaker.
Oh, we moved it.
We did? Okay, good. That's the Hemingway daiquiri, man. Shout out to Ernest Hemingway.
Yeah.
Even though you didn't want to add the grapefruit juice, I don't even know if that was a thing. Does Cuba have grapefruit?
I mean, I don't see why not. It's tropical there. They probably grow lemons, limes, all kinds of things. I'm definitely sure they probably grow limes there.
Yeah.
I mean, California can grow lemons. I'm pretty sure Cuba can grow lemons and limes and grapefruits. And,
yeah. I don't know. All right. That's the Hemingway daiquiri. So you want to get a... Here you go. What as...
Put in one of those cups. I'm going to wash it out.
Well, they're both full.
Okay. I'm going to wash this out.
Oh, wait. Okay.
Oh, she needs to be washed out.
Yeah,
probably. I mean,
yeah, so while she washes it out, I'll just sit here and entertain y'all.
Shots for me.
Okay. Look at that. You're a natural. Bam's a natural. Alright, so next we're going to get into the mojito, which a lot of people like. I personally... hey, what's up, Lisa? I personally hate making it. Because it's messy, because you're dealing with leaves, you know. You got enough leaves to muddle and orange. Alright. So, I don't really like making mojitos. If I'm at a restaurant that doesn't have mint, I'm pretty happy because I don't want to make them. But they are nice, tasty, refreshing drinks. And I will make one, and to my best ability, I will give it my full.
Yeah.
You know, I just don't usually do it.
Alright, well, this is a mojito.
Alright, let's go. You want to talk, before you make it, you
want to
talk
about it? Oh, yeah. Well, let me tell you about the mojito before. I looked up some stuff, like I was at school. No, but the mojito came from Havana, Cuba, which is weird because I did not know that, you know, that daiquiri and the mojito really had a lot in common.
Yeah.
The same guy, Hemingway. Ernest Hemingway is... That was like one of his favorite drinks whenever he was in Cuba. So he would always present the same drink, was the mojito. And the daiquiri was like his one of his two favorites to like present to people. You know what I'm saying? first of all, the mojito really came from a guy named Sir Francis Drake. He was an English sea captain and an explorer who visit Havana in 1586. That was a long time ago. 1586. I can't even imagine what that world looked like, you know?
Right.
Like, what did it look like? I could just see, like, a bunch of trees and...
Yeah, natural stuff.
Like, is it road? Like, when was roads?
Well, I think it just depends on the civilization.
Yeah, you know, like was trains
any
happening?
People on here want to tell us where and when, like... But it was probably the Romans, though, because the Romans used to do everything. So I feel like they were probably the... Because they were the first, I believe, to really develop a water system. But I don't even know if that's true, because I'm sure in Africa they had, like, different things like that.
Yeah.
So.
Don't tell me.
Right. But anyway.
But it was first...
Oh, shit. The mojito was really first like a drink that people drank when they were sick. It's like if you would think about like a hot toddy. Mm-hmm. We think that hot toddies are the cure of it all. But that's how they thought mojitos were. But if you think about it, without the soda water, it really tastes like a lemon juice. It has mint and stuff in there. And it has alcohol, so it makes you makes you sweat out your sickness. Right. And that's why hot toddies came to me.
I'm just saying
hot toddies just because we thought it was used for medical reasons. And mojitos was originally made with brandy. It was originally made with a Portuguese brandy. I don't know how to pronounce it, but I'm just going to say Portuguese brandy.
Right.
before it got its own name, mojito, they used to call it mojo.
It reminds me of Powerpuff Girls.
It reminds me of Austin Powers.
Okay.
Yeah, because Austin Powers.
You know, his mojo.
I feel you,
Austin Powers.
The mojo was like a Cuban seasoning made from lime and stuff that they like, you know, used to season their stuff with. I feel like I had something good I wanted to say about this. Really, that's it. I mean, they used to call it burning water. That was one of the things they called.
Burning water.
Yeah. What I can't pronounce.
We're talking about the mojito.
Yeah, we're talking about the mojito. Yeah, we're talking about the mojito. But, yeah, that's all I have to say about that. So, let's go into the mojito.
And we have some, like, nice music back here. Like, wait a
All right, so with the mojito, we're gonna use six mint leaves. And when I usually make a mojito, you have a whole leaf, I break it.
Yeah,
you wanna break it just so you won't have really big chunks of mint inside your drink. You have to like fight through the mint and the ice and the juice and liquor and all that other stuff.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna break my leaves up just so I can get a nice little green tint for y'all.
No, you're not that late. You are kind of late. But
yeah, you late. We made a drink already, but you can also go back and watch and give us some views.
Right. Thank you. And please share if you guys can.
Yeah, for sure.
Because this is free knowledge. And it's entertaining. Last time we talked about, all week, every time I talk to Bam, I talk about R. Kelly's Christmas room. That has been the talk of the town for me, like, since last Thursday, since last week.
Well, for real, though. All right.
Someone
will have to. Look at it. Someone will wash this out.
Oh, God, man. Come on.
It's orange. That's how we're going to.
She's dramatic, man.
You don't want the mojito to be a little orange.
Yeah,
cherry juice in now. All right, so I got my. Ooh, actually, before you
have
put
you
your ice.
Yet?
No.
Do you have a muddle?
Yes. I'm sorry, I went backwards. I got to talking. But before you put your ice, you want to do an ounce of lime juice. I'm going to put a little bit more.
Okay.
And then do an ounce of simple syrup.
I don't even need it, so you use much.
And I'm going to just put a little bit left, just because we have a big glass.
Yeah.
And then you get your muddler, and your muddler is like this little tool that you can have. It has little things on it, and it basically smashes up whatever you're trying
to do. It extracts the juices from whatever you use.
Yeah.
You know
what I'm saying? Especially, I mean, if you have fruit and stuff, if it helps break down that fruit into your drink.
It'll do that. It definitely helps with leaves, though, because you can make things with anything. I've never made anything with parsley, but
you can actually, regular has a basil mojito that's really, really good.
Okay.
And we use basil and mint. Well, I do, so. So I'm gonna smash it over here. And it definitely sticks to the bottom of your thing, so make sure you shake that out. Let's put our ice. And then we're gonna do this. Use the Bacardi, and I'm gonna do an ounce and a half of Bacardi. Bacardi Limon, actually.
You can use any rum, you know. We just chose to go with
more sweeter. Yeah. Oh, actually, I didn't.
We just chose to go, yeah, with the Bacardi Limon. We actually learned about this recipe from a restaurant we used to work at together, Bravo. And so, this is what they used, and I just loved it. I thought it gave the mojito. I think the mojito can be kind of bland sometimes.
Yeah.
And so, just put some stuff on it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I feel like it really just, I feel like it really just gave it a really good taste.
Yeah.
I can't make sure it's like that.
Because with at Bravo, they use raspberries, which was really, really good.
Oh, it was a pain in the ass. Though.
I loved it. I don't know why.
Yeah.
All right, so we're going to do a little shake and shake.
Yep. We're shaking.
Right. I don't know if it's going to fill up, but we don't see.
Yeah, see, that's what, remember I was saying. The ice gives it, people don't want stuff with ice, and then you make it. I made actually a Long Island for somebody without ice one time. And I guess he thought he was going to get something. I guess he thought he was really going to fill the glass up. Maybe with Coke, yes, but I can't just fill the glass up with liquor and sugar.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just leave it in.
Yeah.
That's why I usually use the ice, but we work on crushed ice. Alright.
I'm going to get a little bit of leaves out of here.
Right, so we can make it look pretty. We want it to look pretty. That's the point. People like to walk around with a pretty
sexy dress.
Yeah, exactly.
Alright, some soda water. Yep. Top it off.
Some people top it with spray. I think to give it some flavor. But I don't think that's how it should be done personally.
And you see how easy this is that we literally got ingredients to make at the house? Yes, you need a bar for us.
Right.
But you don't need a bar. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can literally do this stuff by yourself.
Yeah.
And then...
let me show you how to do Q with the straw.
Okay, Q, stretch that thing on.
Yeah, it's not long enough like the ones we have.
Uh-huh.
Usually I try to make it really cute.
Then we're going to put this on the side if that looks right. And I kind of want to, like... put this in the inside just because I like when the lime is like also.
It's pretty, man.
Thank you. And then we got the little light shining, and that's your mojito, baby.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's it. It's in there.
Yeah. That's how
so
I feel.
So that's it. Yeah. This is the mojito. And well, the daiquiri's gone now. But that's the other drink that we made tonight too.
Yeah. And that's our drinks.
Yeah, and if you miss it, then I'll post it. We also have a YouTube page. I'll post it on YouTube. We'll have some merch coming here soon. What else I want to tell you guys? What? How is it?
It's good.
Give me a make you want.
What you want to do?
I could just have a straw.
Oh, I forgot about this. There you go. There you go, baby. There you go.
That's beautiful, isn't it?
Talking about you trying to go to the beach. Boom.
Yeah, for real. So, man, what you want to talk about now? What's been going on in the world?
What's been going on in the world? First of all, the world is opening back up. How do y'all feel about that? Because that's kind of weird.
So, how do y'all feel? The world will be opening. Where I work at Cannibal and Crab will be open Friday and Saturday. And yes, we will be using full capacity. So, the where is business casual, if you're coming. Downstairs is more like a prohibition type style. Upstairs is the Tiki Bar, aka Club. We usually have live music. We usually have music. Live music downstairs and the DJ upstairs. This weekend in particular, I'll be upstairs. And, we had some complications with that. For some reason, I thought I couldn't put it in the freezer. I cooled the glass with it, but it's batteries. And I put batteries, if you already know, people put batteries in the freezer. So I probably couldn't do that. But anyway, yeah.
I'm definitely coming through Cannibal Grapple. Cannibal and Crapple Saturday.
Yeah, it's going down, man. It's going down. Yeah. Y'all, if you live in the area and have not been, you should come. It's fantastic. Arkansas definitely, but Little Rock has nothing like this bar. It's a total different feel. You will feel like you're just in a different place. You know, it's sad that we have to fantasize about being like somewhere else. But yeah, there you go. Bam is a pro. She is a pro.
I am a pro. Woo woo. Yeah, the world do need to open up. I mean,
yeah.
Without COVID, you know, I'm still like aware of COVID because I know it sucks, but
where the money reside, where the money reside, where the money reside. Where the... But for real, like, COVID was traumatic. It's time to like try to move on from that if we can. Cases here anyway are steadily going down. I hope that's the case for everywhere. So yeah,
Friday is trending. All right, Saturday, everybody meet at Cannibal and Crab. Upstairs,
it's called Cannibal and Crab. It's where the old Ernie Biggs used to be.
Yeah.
Boom, across from Gus's.
We're just gonna have a party there. We can just, instead of on live, we can just drink together.
Jeez. Right. Let's do it. For real. I'll be bartending, so I will be doing, well, I will be working very hard, sweaty, tired. People will be calling my name, saying, Taylor! And I'll be like, yo! I'm in the weeds. You know what I'm saying? Like, but I got you. Man, bartending is such a high stress level job, for real.
Yeah, you definitely gotta have some mental capacity and
you'll cry. People that's not ready will cry.
Oh man, I've seen so many servers and bartenders cry. Overwhelmed. Just crying because they're like, it's never ending. What the?
It's too much. Yeah, I'm upstairs. We're going to party. Come Friday if y'all can. But definitely Saturday, business casual is, you know.
And we're going to be in there, y'all.
Yeah, we in there.
So tap
live
in.
Live music there. Yeah, we're doing live music downstairs. Come through. Come through. And it wouldn't be wise to, like, come through for that on a weekend, like a Friday or Saturday. But definitely get in contact with them, and if you do have music, I encourage you to get in contact and see, you know, what you guys can work out. Because that was Bree.
That's Bree. Actually, y'all, I don't know if y'all know her, but her name is Bree, and she had a live performance. Or I don't even know
what it was. Yeah, that was dope.
It was amazing with that jazz, blues, whatever. Like that was amazing.
Dope.
That was amazing,
dope.
Yo. Y'all, for sure, go on. Go on Bree page, y'all, and watch that live. Like, she's boom.
You don't have any of that information? Random, like the Christmas song? That's the one thing I will voice a complaint about, Rom. It's like you can't get in there.
No, you gotta take a... Because rum is light, you know what I'm saying? It's like it's supposed to cruise you into what you're trying to do.
Yeah.
And then you start taking your own shots because you're like not there yet and you need to get there. So you're like, hey, might as well take tequila.
Right. Exactly.
But it's beachy, you know. And the beach is so cold. I mean, so hot. So you need light drinks. So you don't need anything like
that's why I drink gin.
Because then you don't want to drink all day. So you like need that like kapow. Rum don't get you that capayo. You can like definitely finish a bottle of rum straight.
We can for sure.
Yeah.
If we can, you can.
Alright, so what we got y'all, what do y'all want us to do next week? I'm kind of thinking more on some tequila, maybe.
I was thinking about tequila.
She hates tequila. I love it.
I have acid reflux. I get heartburn.
And tequila is an actual like a laxative. Like it actually breaks down your stuff.
If you're full, take a shot of tequila.
Yeah. Remy Martin is too, right?
Heck yes it is.
So if you need to poop, get you a shot of tequila and then get you there.
Right. Remy Martin is like apple juice. Man, I listened to this song earlier. I was jamming.
I appreciate this song now that I'm older.
But when you was younger, you...
I'm like, this song is lame.
Yeah.
So now you're like...
Is
this Welcome to Miami?
Yeah.
Oh my God, literally I was singing this song at work today.
For real?
I don't even know how that popped in my head. I wasn't even thinking about him.
Connected. All right. Oh, crap. I gotta tell y'all about... how y'all feel about wine?
I feel like wine would be kind of later day. I feel like,
if we're going to make a drink with it, we'll make a sangria with it or something.
Yeah, but I feel like I would also want to do, like, a wine presentation,
I've given up on wine. I drink, so that wine is not, taste-wise, it's really not doing too much for me.
Yeah.
Drink.
But people love wine. People love wine.
They like carrying that glass around.
Yeah. And then, too, like, people don't like to drink alcohol during the week, so I think a good wine will
And that's what they use for that. Say, I'm just drinking wine, but I mean,
you drinking
it in there.
Yeah, I can definitely finish a bottle of wine. And
when I try to stop drinking liquor, I'll be like, oh, I'll just drink wine. But
I'm two bottles down.
Not giving what's supposed to be gay. I wasted my money.
Wasted my money.
Seriously,
yeah.
Man.
Wine is definitely a talk about.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Because rum always make you feel like you're high. Every time I drink rum, I always feel high.
That's like champagne. And I guess wine kind of the same
champagne.
Thing. Let me tell you, if you want to have you a good laugh,
and mix it with that Remy, too.
No. Don't drink with Don't mix it with the Remy because you'll be drunk. But if you want to be drunk, mix it with the Remy. Yeah.
I miss you too. That's Brittany Grantham.
Yeah, Brittany Grantham. miss you too. You and your mom.
Right. I need a read.
Now they was on some wine.
On
the
wine.
That wine. It wasn't even wine. It's wine. It's wine. That's how my mom be like, just me a glass of wine. Like, it's a wine. But, you want
to go?
Give me a glass of wine.
A what?
Give me a glass of wine.
That's a blast. Give me a glass of wine. Oh, Lord. Oh, shoot. I'll hook y'all up on the readings. All right, bet. I need some some balance in my life right now.
Been healing.
For real. I'm not playing.
Yeah.
Then that's what Kanye West for y'all.
So, yeah. You know.
That's it. I forgot again. I want to tell y'all about Bacardi.
Yeah.
It's a lot. It's so uninteresting after you've had a few, but or uninteresting, interesting. Bacardi found February 4th, 1862 in Cuba by Maso is his last name. It was cheaply made, so it was kind of frowned upon, like a poor people's drink.
Rum.
Bacardi in particular. Yeah, rum. But this is about Bacardi though.
Well, they ain't know about it like that.
And that's so crazy because I would say, I mean, Bacardi not one of the superiors, but they're pretty up there.
Well, because what they have to do with so much in history. So yeah. Check this out. Bacardi, man. So the dude got he started making it. Took him 10 years to get the technique down to produce what Bacardi is.
Mm-hmm.
His brother joined in, bought it with him. He had another brother that actually in the 1890s, he was in prison for being a rebel for Cuba's independence. That has a lot to do with the Bacardi family. The Bacardi family also supported rebels that were fighting for their Cuban independence. So Bacardi, but to me, Bacardi basically is the rum of Cuba. It is the drink of Cuba.
Yeah.
Because they rum, help fight for everything.
I mean, yeah, it really is.
Yeah. That's basically it. Because I go into her similar right here. But yeah, that's the story on Bacardi. I'll definitely be supporting Bacardi a little bit more.
Yeah, for sure.
Now that I know that about them.
I like that the brother... It's the song. I like that the brother...
This Malik Black Party.
Hey, from Little Rock.
Yeah, make sure y'all check that out. It's called I Hope You Know.
I thought like we was doing a commercial. But I really like Bacardi.
You like commercials?
I like the commercial. I like Bacardi because of the brother.
Who fought for the
He was
people?
Like a Black Panther, but not saying he was. You know, yeah. The same
But for Cuba, you know what I'm saying? He was fighting for their independence.
Yeah,
so
I feel like that's a bold thing. I can't imagine.
Yeah. And knowing your family has this whole thing going on, too.
Yeah.
You know? No, he went to prison and everything.
And your family making money through Bacardi.
Yeah. So that's the interesting fact on Bacardi.
So there you have it.
When you look at Bacardi, think about that. What time is it? It's 8:44, so we're almost at our hour. I so needed that laugh.
Well, I feel like y'all being some boring Bettys right now.
Right. So we're gonna go have fun.
Cause y'all not trying to. Y'all don't wanna comment.
No.
And dance with us and drink.
No.
But we're gonna keep giving you this knowledge every Thursday.
Every single Thursday. We'll stay consistent. So when you wanna tune in, when you can tune in, I know everybody's like have their own life going on.
It's summer coming up, so hey, you know.
Yeah. So I have some different ideas for what we're gonna do during the summertime too to make it a little bit more entertaining. Yeah. Maybe next or one of the Thursdays we'll go out. I don't know if y'all even ready to see that. but yeah. Thank you, Brittany. So we're gonna end it here. Rum drinks. The bottom line is Cuba has went through a lot and produced some great stuff.
Oh, some great stuff.
And Ernest Hemingway is the bomb.
He is the bomb.
Yeah.
Because it's the second week that we like did something that has something related to him. So.
Yeah. He was a drinker.
We need to really
talk about me like that.
Yeah.
I made this drink because
I love this
drunk it. Taylor came in my bar.
And we need to follow in his footsteps, man. We're going to go to Cuba, y'all, and just like do a show in Cuba.
Yeah.
And we're going to like do.
Yeah, we're going to be like, give me the Ernest Hemingway drink. And the bartender going to be like, Jesus. Another Ernie's person. Like, you know, they start, did you know? You know, they started telling you about this stuff. It's crazy.
Yeah.
All right. You drank it, Lil Mo. He didn't have it, you.
Well, I poured you something that you've been neglecting.
Oh, my God. And I wanted another drink. This may be extended live now.
Oh, Lord.
What do you think about Cuevas?
It's fire. I want to get up and dance
up
and rain.
In the club. Dancing rain? Dancing rain and
only because Omarion dancing rain, but I just did that because R. Kelly was like speaking. And I feel like he don't have...
We've been listening to R. Kelly the last week. And you enjoyed it.
Sometimes I just have my moments where I'm just like...
Think about the music, man.
Like, I listen to a podcast that's called Serial Killers, y'all. And when I say that... All the stuff... Well, I don't really know his story. And
the
Hawk
tie in too?
Huh?
The Hawk tie in too?
I mean... I feel like all the stuff that I heard about him is he's a serial killer. Serial killers always have that certain age, that certain thing that they like. That's just, they'd be married, y'all, with folk girls and rape nothing but 10-year-old girls.
That's what you're going to tell your kids. I used to watch these, I used to listen to these 2020?
Podcasts. Hey, I don't love it, but I love learning about serial killers because they have the same exact traits and characteristics, but it's just so weird just the way they just weird stuff.
You look
like for real.
It's weird. Like, came off.
I know. Like it was okay.
Y'all.
I know this is like not what we come here for. Welcome to this podcast. On the Serial Killer podcast. And it was about this guy. He was a little feminine. He was gay. And he liked 10-year-old boys. And his sister had a son. And he wanted to... he was spoiled. So he basically asked his parents to give him a farm. So he could basically use it for farming. Like a chickens and goats and stuff. But he really was wanting to use it to store bodies. So he manipulated his sister to have his nephew come work with him, and he kept his nephew hostage. Like, he raped him, he beat him, he starved him, and he even had his nephew help kill the little boys. You know, he would keep the little boys hidden, and he would help him kill them, and it was a lot, you know? So, I feel like people need to learn about serial killers, because
it's real out here.
It's real out here, y'all. It's still happening. So, yeah, and yes, black men can be serial killers too, so watch out.
I knew Bam had a story for me. I knew it. After the R. Kelly Christmas room.
And also, his mother helped him kill somebody. And she took the fall just because she didn't want to see her son go down. You know?
Well, that's a loyal mama. If that's I was a loyal doing mama. All that, I would hope my mama come through.
Come through. I feel like my mama would come through. My mama would like, I did it.
She might. She'd be like, did nobody do it?
I did it. But no, that's messed up.
Yeah.
Because he was just gay. I hated him. I was listening to that story. I was like, nasty. Nasty old.
Alright.
Nah, so yeah.
You needed to share that with the people, didn't you?
Because I haven't shared it with nobody yet today.
You listen to it today?
I listen to it today, and I'm just at work like, nasty. It's just the stuff that they would do, you know, the amount of. Like, he almost stole a kid, like, in broad daylight. He was, his family was
right
there.
That's how addicted he was.
That's how addicted he was craving. Like his nephew was like, I know, like, he's not messing with me no more. Because he got uninterested in his nephew because his nephew was getting older.
Getting older, yeah. I watch a lot of Law & Order SVU. Dun, dun. Dun, dun. Dun, 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 dun. Man, I used to make you watch it.
And that's why I don't like it now.
You used to be mad at the end, though. You'd be like, I'll never tell what happened.
Because SVU would definitely give you a 2B continue, but it's really not a 2B continue.
Yeah. You're like, what's going to happen? I don't want to know. I'm like,
how would this cut off? Like, I'm just like left with wondering, like, did they catch the person? Did, like, did they get closure? I need a 2B continue.
What's going on?
I need beyond.
It's like the ring. I got a new ring light today, y'all. And yeah, the ring light is so bright. It's making me squint.
It is making me squint a little bit. That's why I can't look at the phone.
Okay.
Like,
yeah. I'm doing light skin eyes. But it's about 9 o'clock, so no longer than an hour. We're about to go. Thanks all of you guys that did tune in. And I appreciate y'all, and we appreciate y'all.
Heck yeah.
And we'll be back next Thursday. I don't know what we're gonna make, what we're gonna drink, or anything like that. But
we got y'all.
Hopefully, yeah. Hopefully,
by Monday, she's a way better marketer than I am. I have time off.
Yeah, it doesn't matter though. So, thank y'all very much for tuning in. If you tuned in, share this, do whatever you can. If you don't watch it, I appreciate it. And we'll talk to y'all next time.
Peace to the Middle East.
Not to the Middle East.
Do we still say peace to the Middle East?
I don't know. Is that politically correct now?
I don't know.
Peace to the Middle East? Well, they need peace, so yeah.
They need peace.